Hi, my name is Aaron Powell. I'm a principal cloud advocate here at Microsoft, and today we're going to have a look at some demos of how we can use the arrow function, or the fat arrow function as you might also know it as, in JavaScript. I'm going to start by declaring a fat arrow function in JavaScript. Now we have to do that by assigning it to a variable. So let's create one and we'll call it add, at which we'll take two numbers and add them together. So we'll take two arguments, then we use our arrow characters, so which is the equal sign, and then the greater than symbol. And in my text editor and using the font that I've got, it actually looks like an arrow, and this is where it gets its name, fat arrow. And then in this, we'll do add A and B, so using the plus operator to combine them together. And now we can do console.log. And this is then used just the same way as you would use a traditional function in JavaScript. We'll do add, and we'll do 1, 2. So if we save this, and then we'll run it from here in our console, and we get, as we expect, 3 as the output. Now, what's interesting about the arrow function that I've defined here is that it's got an implicit return statement. I haven't had to use the return keyword to make this happen. I've just added those two together. And this is because in a single line JavaScript function that's defined using the arrow function syntax, it is going to be treated as an implicit return. So whatever the result of the operation you've got on this line is going to be returned as the output of that function. This does mean that you can't do things like declare a variable with inside of an arrow function that doesn't have a multi-line feature enabled for it, because you don't have the ability to do a variable declaration and have that return something. That would be invalid syntax. We can still create an arrow function that does work across multiple lines. So we'll create a new function. Oops, not console.log, we'll do const. And we'll call this one subtract. And we'll take an A and a B. In this case, we're going to use the squiggly brackets to create a block. And inside of this block, we now can treat it like we would a traditional JavaScript function. We can have multiple lines. So I could do const result is going to be A minus B. And then we can return using the return keyword and return result. Now, in a multi-line arrow function, we have to be explicit about our return using the return keyword. This is because it's treated then like a normal function block, and we don't know where that function might end, so we use the return keyword in that case. And also, this means that a multi-line JavaScript function defined with the arrow syntax can also not return a value. Well, in true, it will actually return undefined implicitly, because a function that doesn't use the return keyword won't return a value. It will return undefined. So if we do console.log of subtract 1 and 1. Now if we do console.log and run our demo, we'll see that we get 0. So we get what we would expect. And our function works the same as we would with any other functions in JavaScript, just we're able to use the arrow syntax and take some advantages of some shorter character count in maybe our response if we're sending this down in a browser, or fewer keystrokes if you're a little bit of a slacker developer like myself. But also we have the ability to do implicit returns by having a single line function with no squiggly brackets around it to denote a function block. But we can still have multiple lines if we so desire and we need to inside of our function. So that's a quick look at how we can use functions using the arrow syntax in JavaScript. See you next time.